kati tuwa kafuna mikono chikumu asatu mwemu tu subira nti by close of week oban ale next week wanga bancha bamba tukubidi bali mu byalo bamba koma Friday Saturday so tu subira nti Monday Tuesday tujabba wa update kuba baka bameka abatadde ko mukono so njagala kusaba abo bonna abakyali mu byalo nti wetuli tusubira nti by next week tujja kufulumya list. Njagala kusaba bana Uganda bonna okutegeera nti kye tukola kino. Tetugoberera muntu nti tuli ku muntu gundi ffe tulwanyisa nguzi ate tetwagala kulaba nguzi wano mu Parliament. Bakomishona bantu baffe ffe tulina okubalonda wadde baabaleeta mu baabaleeta ne babawa ebifo mu ngeri etategerekeka kubanga amateeka agatufuga nga Parliament gagamba nti tulina okubalonda tetwabalonda. Ekikulu neewuunyisa olwaleero okulaba the Honorable Nwaga omuntu gwe mpa nnyo respect ekitiibwa okuba nti ajja wano ku addressing a media n'agamba nti akawairo ke tuyiseemu si katuufu kati ye alinze ki okujja okututereza n'atugamba nti akawairo ke muyiseemu si katuufu. Twasoma petition mawulire yonna mumanyi petition bye badde yogera twogera ku ssente akawumbi kamu ne million nsanvu abakomishona ze bagabanya twogera ku ssente ze beeyongeza mu ngeri emenya amateeka twogera twagala bakomishona batubuulira obuyinza babugyewa okwegabanya ssente so bwe tugamba ekyo tutunulira engeri ki gye tusobola okubayita okwa accountinga akawairo rule 110 rule 10 yes 10 gye tusinzidde kubanga okujjawo commissioner teyenkana n'okujjawo minister oba speaker oba president abo oyina okuyita ate akawairo akalala. So eno kawairo ke tuyisemu kakujjawo ba commissioner akawairo kagamba nti tulina okufuna emikono 10 7 6 bwe tumala okufuna ezo then ne tuwaayo petition eri clerk alyoka abuulire speaker nakiteeka ku order paper. So njagala kubabuulira nti kalebule etambula bavudde ku ekyo kawairo kati bazzeemu ssente mbunze saro pendi abasiyazi bampadde ssente abamu boogera nti nafunye akawumbi kamu mu million 200 nzize nti tuwa abantu ssente banna abalina ssente mubamanyi era bali mu kutambula okukuulira bantu toteekako omukono tujja kuwa ssente sinafuna ssente okuvaawo omusiyazi yonna ate njagala kusaba abantu ab'omu Parliament n'abakulembeze bonna twawule enguzi ku bisiyaga buli bwe boogera ku nguzi nti abo basiyazi be balwanisa enguzi bwe mwali mugabana ssente abasiyazi baaliwo mulekeraawo okututabula. Honorable Abdul Katuntu chairperson owakakiiko akempisa akakwasa empisa kati bw'ajja wano n'atandika okwogera ku process eno tunagenda wa njagala basaba muleme kubeera babaka muleme kubeera ng'abantu be basindika businzi nsaba buli mubaka yenna kozesa obwongo nga tonaba kuwogera kozesa obwongo okutunuulira nti kino kye tulwanisa kujjawo bakomishona abamenya amateeka ne beggabanya ssente tetulwanisa muntu yenna waliwo abaleeta ne bagatwagala kugata mu sipiika okujjawo sipiika tetusobola kuyita mu kawairo 10 mu 10 ebyo bibeera birala tuli kuba komishona buli memba wa Paalamenti yenna nkusaba baayo mbamanyi abamubuli mu byalo abamu bali bweru batambudde tubalinze by next week tujja kufulumya list unfortunate for a senior member of the House, who is also a shadow attorney general, to come and make statements which are contrary to our rules. We consulted legal minds before we actually moved this motion. And rule 1110 is the rule that we are moving under, because our focus is on the removal of the commissioners, not removal of all members of the parliamentary commission. Our focus is on the four backbench commissioners. And rule 1110 is very clear. You must collect 1/3 of the voting members of parliament, signatures from those members. Once you attain that, then you submit your motion to the clerk. So it defeats my understanding that the Honorable Mwagaba can come and speak to the media, giving what he feels. But we all know that they are behaving like, it's very unfortunate to behave like a hired gun, just hired, making accountability for whoever could have sent them. The Honorable Katundu is the chairperson of the Rules Committee. This matter will eventually go before him. He should not be seen to be speaking or giving a side in all this entire process. And I've heard some members saying that we should have allowed this to go through the internal processes. What other process do we have other than moving under Rule 110, which is very clear? The Honorable Sechikubu severally stood on the floor of the House requesting the Speaker for time for him to make a statement or ask questions. The Honorable Du said he had questions for commissioners. All this was not granted. So I want to tell the Ugandans that please look out for such members of parliament that are jumping or want to put aside our rules so that we follow some other known rule to them for their own. We don't know what their motive is, because we are very clear. All we want is the commissioners to account to us, because we are actually supposed to be electing them. They actually came into office in a manner that flouted our rules, because the rules talk about election of commissioners, not appointment of commissioners. So please allow us as members of parliament to follow the processes that we clearly know. And then the commissioners will be given a chance to explain before the relevant rules, the relevant committee. It may be a select committee, or it may be the committee. The rules can even be suspended, and we handle this matter on the floor of the House.
We are getting reports that you're being controlled, just like some other MPs who are signing, that it's coming random by some MPs who are putting forward. How close do you reckon?
I have stated it categorically clear that there are some people who are bent on tagging corruption allegations every time to homosexuality. I have been informed, the House and members have been called and told that I was given money by homosexuals. And this is the money I am using to bankroll this process. I don't have any money. I don't have any contact with any homosexual, because I don't know of any. I know they exist, but I don't know of any. So let us differentiate corruption and deal with corruption as an issue, but not mixing corruption with homosexuality every time an issue is raised. If monies were not lost, then why are people panicking? I have even seen somebody sending some form of a circular asking members not to sign, that let's exhaust this internally. Which other internal process do we have? So members of parliament, it is my humble appeal to you. You either stand on the right side of the law and do your oversight role even within parliament, or this country will be doomed.